Now, we find in verse 17, a man laden with the blood of any person shall flee to the pit. Let no man stay him. In other words, a man that is consciously guilty of having committed a horrible crime, he has to bear on the conscience a fearful load that'll finally drive a man to suicide. And there's so many cases like that today, and I suppose the prime case is that of Judas Iscariot himself as being the one finally driven to suicide because of the awful, dastardly crime that he had committed. And so many crimes today. An FBI man told me this. He said, you know, sometimes a crime will go for several years. We have no inkling at all of evidence or of being able to trace it. And finally, here pops up a man or even a woman sometimes over here, and they have to talk, and they make a statement. And sometime they're in prison on another crime, and they confess one that he says that we're still working on. Why? Because it's on the mind and heart of an individual, my friend. You can't escape that. God made you that way, hoping that that might bring you back to him. Now, verse 24, whoso robbeth his father or his mother and saith it's no transgression, the same is the companion of a destroyer. Now, a man might say, well, after all, I'm going to inherit what my dad's got, so I'll just take it from him now. Well, that's a crime in God's sight. And by the way, you remember, that was the thing that the Lord Jesus rebuked the religious rulers for in that day, because they had made a tradition that if a man just said Corban, it didn't make any difference if he ignored his parents, you see. Well, you see, it's so easy because of a relationship to deny support or to take something that does not belong to you. And that is the thing that our Lord condemned.